Common cloud characteristics. Hi, I'm Ron Hoag. In this two-part video series, I want to take a look at five common cloud characteristics that you'll find throughout any type of Cloud Essentials training that you'll take. I want to look at five topics: on-demand self-service, broad network access, resource pooling, rapid elasticity, and measured service. Now, if you don't know what any of these are or all of these are, don't worry, we'll cover each of these in detail. These five topics came from NIST. You'll recall that NIST is the National Institute of Standards and Technology, and they created this special publication that explains these five ideas, but what I want to do is put them in more common terms so that they're more easily understood. So let's look at the first, on-demand self-service. In the past, we used to do a mail order for computers, or we would use the internet to purchase computers. We would put in our credit card information or supply payment information over the phone, and then we'd have to wait 2 to 4 weeks for that hardware to get shipped to us and arrive at our location. Now, we can enter credit card information into a cloud provider's website and wait 2 to 4 minutes for these new resources to be ready. So when we talk about on-demand self-service, we're saying that resources like CPU, RAM, and storage space are available on demand. They're available when you need them, and you are the one who can go in and order as much as you'd like and have it available to you as soon as needed. Next is broad network access. What we used to do is we'd have to sit at the physical machine in order to access it. If we purchased a server or we purchased a desktop, we'd have to be at that machine to access it. If we wanted some sort of remote software, if we needed to connect to it from home or anywhere else, we would have to buy third-party software and install it on that desktop or server. Now, we can access machines via laptops, tablets, or even our smartphones, and the software to access it is often free or even built into the service. So when we talk about this idea of broad network access, we're saying that we're able to access our machines anywhere from many different devices, so the network becomes more critical to the operations of our IT infrastructure. Next is resource pooling. We used to have one server that was just ours. Nobody else touched it. We knew exactly where it was. We put it in a specific rack in a specific location, and everything was ours. Now, your server might have many clients, and we talk about it being multi-tenant or having multi-tenancy. Multi-tenant means that the information you're using on this server sits right beside the information that someone else is using on a server, or you're using CPU resources as well as other folks who are using that same server's resources. It's not your server. It's not dedicated just to you. Multiple people can be using it. Now, this is the case in a public cloud. Of course, in a private cloud, that's when we have dedicated resources. But in general, in public cloud, your server is not yours. It is a shared server. That server could also be anywhere on the planet. You don't necessarily know where it is, and that could be a risk. In the next video, we'll cover those last two characteristics, so make sure you check those out as well. And if this is good stuff, like it, tweet it, subscribe it, and share it. I'm Ron Hoag. I'll see you in the next video.